Hi everyone. Well, I'm Canek Zapata. I live in Mexico City. I think I really I don't know much about code because I studied classical literature, that is Greek and Latin, old Greek and Latin, and then I suppose I always wanted to be a well to write poetry, and then I suppose I discovered Photoshop, and Photoshop gave me the opportunity to do something different. And I was like a, I don't know, no future dropout who work doing, I don't know, writing stuff for other people. And then I started to do Photoshop, and it has been really, really fun. So I suppose I am a net artist, but I mainly work in poetry, or I don't know, algorithmic poetries. I know Lupita and Rodrigo Adlo work that way, and I suppose that was because, well, that's why Olivia got us up here. Otherwise, I really invite your praise, Lupita. I am in the cool city, and you are in the outdoors with green stuffs.
But only because there's Wi-Fi. If there was not, then I wouldn't be able to do this. I'm in front of a house.
Yeah. I don't know. Infrastructure is the always permanent condition of internet. No, if we got no infrastructure, we got no. I don't know. And I started working with Hydra like 2 years ago, I suppose, and I really, really, really like it. I do like, I don't know, like BJ for music, and then I don't like to work with video, really, or video editing tools. So I was working with HTML canvas to put GIFs, and then I discovered Hydra, and this is the only Hydra I really, really like. I think it doesn't really work no more in the website. I don't know why, really. I haven't catch up with the latest edition of Hydra. So, but I do a work like a curator and a artist and a publisher. I don't know how this is telling in English, but in Spanish is editor. And I got a electronic literature place to do things. And I will show that place. I don't know, this like website is called Broken English, and I really, really love it because we are, and my friends are, we are, I don't know. Poetry is like very a strange thing with text, and poetry doesn't need really meaning, or doesn't read need really anything particular, a difference, but with prose, ensay, or I don't know, novels and that kind of thing that makes sense. Poetry can be much free. So we are, I don't know, let me, I think my RAM memory is going down. Well, and we have like this electronic literature place. I think we got like 4 years from 5 years, because we started in 2015. So this is the page, and we publish poems and electronic books. They're really, really simple. They are not very complex, like, I don't know, Rodrigo stuff or something like that, but this is one of that. It's a poem a love poem for Carl Sagan from an American writer that is called Robin Myers. And I don't know, I think I stole the code from another NetArt page. I think it was Jody's page. And then I, by that kind of thing of stealing things from other artists, I don't know, I teach me, and it's very simple, HTML and CSS to do, I don't know, web page. We have like this kind of poem that is very, very silly. You can see the translate in English. But I don't know, it has been very fun because I have the opportunity to know so much young young poets, and it's kind of very fun because poetry is very, I don't know, stiff in Mexico, and I suppose in every country. So the youth poems and the, I don't know, the poems that have cultural reference that are not about poetry itself or metaphysicals or that kind of thing. I suppose that this with Naruto it still is old.
Tú puedes medir mi dependencia hacia ti con el efecto Doppler. Cerca de mi casa hay un parque y en ese parque hay un bulevar de los niños con pequeñas avenidas y semáforos. Ahora déjame explicarte que siempre estoy ahí, corriendo como Naruto alrededor de la pequeña glorieta con los brazos extendidos sin dejar de gritar.
I don't know, this the kind of stuff. That we like poetry that is fun, and I suppose poetry from our generation, we have like bots, Twitter bots here, and books. It's very fun because I can do that that parallel of books and bots, and I really, really love making bots. So I have like we have, I don't know, more than 10 bots here, and I have like a web page made of bots like this. This is, it's called Lipo 18888888. This is a piece about the future and life without human in Earth. So it started like a poem in Spanish, and then I made this page and this other page that are like, I don't know, like, I don't want it to, I think poetry with computer is very high-tech kind of thing of do, so this is like a very, very low algorithm that only combinatory with the words. So then this piece ended up as like a commercial product. We sell with a friend that is called Janet 40, we sell antidote to capitalism that comes from the future. I can show you, let me get intro. It's a rice stuff. You can eat the rice, it's here. A rice that is, I don't know, fluorescent rice, so you can buy it and inoculate yourself from capitalism. I have a video about that I do like a 3D Unity video with Hydra in the middle. So I think, well, sorry that you can see my videos in YouTube. Well, my the things I see in YouTube. It had videos. Nice. I don't know. This is the video. I will not show. I only want to show the like Aida stuff because it's fun.
Decode the change. Govern life on Earth forever.
So, and then I don't know. I work. I told you I work with literature so much. I have this post-it generator. So it came from the idea that I always read and copy-paste things. And then I started to see that I didn't put all the reference of my copy-paste, only the phrase, not the author, not the book. So I think about that, and then I did this piece that is like it got, I don't know, like 1,000 pages of text from different books, and only got citation but no author. And I don't know, I really like it because it talk about art and history and that kind of things I do like media theory and that kind of things. But it's very, I don't know, it's only like a joke for me because I don't have very much order in my post-its. And I then reproduce the same thing, but in a Unicode-based bot. And I really love that because I really, really do love Unicode and all the strange symbols that Unicode do. So I don't know, my Twitter account do this kind of poems with Unicode. So I make mash up in a web page. And like 2 years ago, I make with a friend this oracle in Spanish. This oracle talk about the future with the Máquina Estética, de Manuel Felgueres. Manuel Felgueres was an Mexican artist that in the 70s tried to do like a machine to make this kind of structure about, I think, 8 geometric forms to do his art. So Veronica Gerber, Carlos Bergen, and I did this electronic adaptation of the Máquina Concreta, Máquina Estética, and we called it La Máquina Distópica, the dystopic machine, because we added like a text that Veronica do with Amparo Dávila's poems. And then this year, one of my friends, well, we have like discussed with a lot of friends about how to put digital art in general. So one of my friends, well, one collective of my friends, I suppose, did this Say X Laugh, and in the first of his exposition, one friend's my, and I suppose everyone here, that is Malitzin Cortez. I don't know, she let me use one of his structure, 3D structure, to put pixels acelerados, like accelerate pixels, that is a video made with Hydra. So I don't know if my RAM or internet will support this, because I don't know, internet connection, but you can navigate in a 3D environment. And the one thing that is like blue in the background, this guy, this is the Hydra I make for the piece. And it was very fun because the guys who made this, they got a lot of troubles to make like, video screens in objects, in 3D objects. I really, I suppose I know something about that, but I'm not really an expert about 3GS and that kind of things. I don't know. I think it's all. You can go to read the poems in broken English. We have like a exhibition, like in the Grand Biennale, like the years ago. It called it Todo Mal because the Grand Biennale is the Grand Biennale, so we call it Todo Mal, and it's a very, I think, very large exhibition about literature. And we have this kind of thing like an insight about memes with memes. So thank you for your times.